Good morning, my dear students. As in previous class, I told you to start a first poem, Romeo and Juliet. Romeo and Juliet. Basically, it is a play. It is a play written by William Shakespeare, a famous dramatist as well as poet. In 16th century, he has written 33 plays and 154 sonnets. And as a playwright and poet, he is known to this world. We can say world famous writer. All over world, most of the countries, they have published in their language dramas of William Shakespeare. Then for your PUC second year, I request all my students not to confuse. It is play. And in this PUC second year, first chapter, Romeo and Juliet, but only two conversation dialogue, we can say, it has taken and prescribed for this our PUC second year. So Romeo and Juliet, written by William Shakespeare. Whenever we listen Romeo and Juliet, suddenly in our mind it comes that they are great lovers in this world. So Verona, that city has become nowadays monument. Why? Because of these two lovers belonged, they stayed, they lived in that city. Let us see here in this poem, Romeo and Juliet. So before that, outline a theme to explain, I want to just show this one. Two noble families of Verona. So here they are the dignified families, Romeo as well as Juliet's. Both they are what here? Dignified families. Then here Capulet family, Montagu's family, these two families, Capulet family and Montagu's family. So Juliet belongs to Capulet's family and Romeo belongs to Montagu's family. Noble family, no other word to say, they are noble families. And one thing we to be remembered, that they are enemies, means dead enemy one another. So in this poem Romeo and Juliet, we know that Juliet belongs to Capulet and Romeo belongs to Montagu's family. And then Mercutio, a best friend of what? Romeo. Best friend. Usually in our life we will have what? Best friend. So here Montagu, best friend. And in this side Juliet family, here Rosaline. Rosaline, niece of Lord Capulet. Here she belongs to Capulet and niece of Lord Capulet, Rosaline. Tybalt, cousin. So this is what here, some characters, few characters we should know. But when we come to here, it is directly related to this what? Romeo and Juliet. So let us see here today. Romeo, what he will say, see, background, we should know background to imbibe this small theme. In this what theme, to better understand, we have to know background. So here Romeo and Juliet, written by William Shakespeare, and he has born in 1564 and 1616 he passed away, and he belongs to 16th century. He has written so many plays as well as poems, and here for you this Romeo and Juliet in the form of what? Here poetry means to conversation they have prescribed. Let us see what we can see in this what to conversation. So noble families, two noble families of Verona. Verona is a famous city. In that city these two families used to stay, but basically they are what here? Enemies. They are enemies. And Capulet family, Juliet belongs to Capulet family, Romeo belongs to Montague's family. So that is what here we should know. Then background here, the two noble families of Verona, the Capulet and the Montagues, were staunch enemies. They are what? Enemies one another. Romeo and Juliet belongs to rival families. They are what? Belongs to rival families. Old Lord Capulet means old Lord Capulet here arranged a grand party. Here what we see here, he arranged what? Grand party. Capulet, Lord Capulet, old Lord Capulet arranged party. Then though Romeo belongs to the family of Montagues, he attended the party in disguise to see Rosaline, here niece of Lord Capulet, to see Rosaline by the advice of his friend. He will attend in the form of, means not to identify him, because they are rival families, not to identify him as a Romeo, he will disguise and then go to attend party arranged by this old Lord what here Capulet family, means Juliet belongs to that family, and here Romeo went to see Rosaline there. So it was arranged, everybody, they are just coming, and he too went there to attend to see Rosaline, and there he will see Juliet on the dance floor, and he is fascinated by her beauty. So when you will enter, suddenly you will have a look of Juliet, and that her fascinated beauty made him to become stunned, silent, flat, we can say. So that beauty, her beauty, she was so beautiful, and he will forget when he will enter. Suddenly he will have a look of that beauty, Juliet, and he will stand there itself, and he will see. then she too, here she too feels a prodigious birth of love for a man from the enemy family. So she too felt that first time to fall in love with that gentleman. So like that, both of them express their implicit feeling for one another. So both they will see one another. They started here, unquestionable feelings from them it comes. So that is what here. They are not talking one another, just expression. What he felt in his mind by seeing a beauty of Juliet, he started, means Romeo started expressing whatever the feelings comes in his mind. So himself, see here, soliloquy is nothing but here talking to oneself. He started what? Thinking her beauty himself. Directly he will not go and speak with that Juliet, and whatever the feelings comes in his mind, he will express. So that we can see here, Romeo's expressions we can see here. And Romeo, he will start expressing from his bottom of his heart. So he will say like that, "Oh, she doth teach the torches to burn bright. It seems she hangs upon the cheek of night." Cheek of night. So here, her beauty surpass a more brighter than which, what here? Light. Means here, burn bright, torches, means here, her demonstration, her beauty surpasses all over. So she was so beautiful. So everybody what here presented in that party, but Juliet presence made more brighter because of what here? Her beauty. She doth, means does, she does teach the torches to burn bright, means her presence, maybe beauty, surpasses brighter. It seems she hangs upon the cheek of night. So everybody, her presence made everyone to be happy. That her demonstration on floor dance made everyone to be what? Happy. As a rich jewel in an Ethiopia's ear, beauty too rich for use, for earth too dear. So once again, these two lines, what the poet want to say here, he want to say that as a rich jewel in an Ethiopia's ears, means here African black lady, Ethiopians means black lady, when she wore here ornaments, how it will be looking shining brighter. So her beauty was like that. So simple. Here comparison. This Romeo will be comparing beauty of what here? Juliet's to that what? Ornaments. How it will be shining on black lady. So that he will compare that beauty. Her beauty was like that. So that is what here. Beauty too rich for use, for earth too dear. So here she is too beautiful. Means here beauty too rich for use. She is beautiful in this world. World and too beautiful to die and to be buried. See, too beautiful to die. So that beauty, her beauty made him to think that she is beautiful, too beautiful to die and to be buried. So here her beauty stand permanent. So she was extraordinary. This feelings, implicit feelings comes from bottom of the heart, from this what here, Romeo. So that is what here. So shows a snowy dove trooping with crows as yonder lady over her fellows shows. So what happens in that party? Maybe fellows, her friends, everybody, they were there. They were happy, celebrating one another in a good, enthusiastic manner. But one thing he felt, Romeo felt. Here, what he will say means, snowy means here, white dove, pigeon. How it will be water in a white color, that pigeon. If he will sit in that crows, how it will be looking? So her beauty is compared to this what? Snowy. Snow means white. Dove means pigeon. So white pigeon. So shows a snowy dove trooping with crows, sitting, trooping, mingling, what? With crows. So everybody that surrounding of that Juliet, she was looking like white dove, but surrounding of that fellows looking like a crows. Means here one thing we should remember, her beauty is compared. So that comparison. So he never saw that type of lady. He has not at all seen in his span of life. So he felt as if he felt that on that night, that to love someone, it has budded. It has started in his not only mind, even in his heart. So that is the thing we can see here. Yes, yonder lady over her fellows shows. Yonder means standing, sitting there with her friends. We can see that. So she is like a white, snowy dove, white pigeon. She was looking like that to him. Not to him, she was like that. Most beautiful at that time in 16th century. One who will see a quite natural, that feeling will come. So he too got, and he never saw that type of what lady. So all the expressions comes within what here? Oneself. By him it comes. The measure done. I will watch her place of stand, and touching hers make blessed my rude hands. See here, after dance, she was standing. Here, place of stand. And he felt to go and just shake her hand, touching hers, make blessed. What he felt, that maybe his hand, my rude hand, if I touch, as if it will be blessed on me. Like that, he felt that her beauty was extraordinary, and he felt to go and where she was standing, he felt to move forward and have a hand shake with that Juliet, and thinking that I have blessed. That is what here. So one thing here we should remember, he is not speaking directly with that what Juliet. He is just expressing, standing there. We know that they are rival families. He is not allowed to enter. He has come in disguise form, not to identify him. In that appearance, he has entered. When he entered, suddenly he saw that lady. She was dancing on the floor, and he thought that she was most beautiful. Until to complete that dance, he was not known that she was what? Rival family. Means here, Capulet's family. Old Lord Capulet daughter. Rival family. He was not known. But at the time of when he had a look on that lady, what we say, love at first sight, that is very suitable to this Romeo, and he will become stunned, flat by seeing her beauty, and he started, means that expression comes, means feelings, continuous overflow of his feelings comes by seeing that beauty which he never saw. That type of lady she was. And then, did my heart, he will question, did my heart love till now? Question mark, say, did my heart love till now? So until on that day, night, he never felt to love someone. But on that day, maybe in his mind, maybe in his heart, he felt, is it to be called love? Like the question arises in his mind. So, did my heart? Because usually this mind is more fickle than this what? Heart. Once if we take a decision, then it is will be constant. So, did my heart love till now? Until that night, he never felt to fall in love with someone. But first time he felt that I should love. If I want to love, I must love with this beauty, means Juliet. Like that he felt. Forswear it, means he will promise. Forswear it, promise. Sight, first sight made him to become fall in love. Sight, for I never saw true beauty till this night. I never saw true beauty till this night. So that is what here. See, the depth, try to see the depth of his feelings. That is very important. Here he is saying that I never saw true beauty. Beauty, true beauty. So usually we are, what? Everyone will have a gifted this what in our facial, one or other organ will be what? Attractive. That beauty will be there. Maybe few that beauty will be in their eyebrows, maybe nose, maybe what here, cheek, whatever it may be. But here he is telling that true beauty. Here, I never saw true beauty. So just we have to imagine that. How beautiful she was. So till this night, until that, on that night, he never saw. So that is what here. Here it is soliloquy, means talking to oneself, means he is talking himself, expressing his views, thoughts by seeing Juliet beauty. So that is what here. See, think here, it is a play written by William Shakespeare, but it is not complete play in your syllabus. Only two conversation, that conversation one part is Romeo's, another one conversation is what? Juliet. So Romeo and Juliet, they have given in the form of, what here, a small poem, two conversation, and only we to be understand feelings, expressions of Romeo at that night when he will see Juliet, whatever the feelings comes from him that he is describing and he is comparing. How his beauty surpassed with that bright light, and how this ornament will be shining on that black lady, Ethiopia's lady, how it will be looking more shining, attractive on her body, that ornaments. She is like that. And comparing friends, she was just looking like a what? Here, snowy dove, means white pigeon, and friends were looking like a crows. So here each line he will be go on comparing beauty, her beauty. At last he will directly keep his strong passion towards her beauty, telling that I never saw true beauty in his life, span of his life, he never saw that true beauty. So and then that is the what here expression we can see. Next comes Juliet. See, remember here first part Romeo express, he will express, and in the play act 1 scene 5, act 1 scene 5 we can see this conversation, Romeo's conversation, feelings, what I explained now. Here act 1 scene 5, that is the what part, a small expression taken and what prescribed you. Act 1 scene 5, in that what main play they have given only expressions of Romeo when he will see in that what party. Her beauty made him to feel like that. So that second here, Juliet. Here, Act 3. In Act 3, Juliet, how she felt? How she felt, she want to express. Once again, here expression we can see. And here Juliet will tell, come night, come Romeo, come though day in night, for though lit lie upon the wings of night. So here, come night, come Romeo, come though day in night, for though lit means you will lie upon the wings of night. Once again, we have to think that her feelings towards Romeo. So, Act 3, in Act 3, Juliet, she will express, come night, come Romeo, come, though day in night. You have entered in my life. Completely, you have entered in my life. Day in night. It may be what night? How his means love, she felt that her love, his love, day in night. And you will lie upon the wings of night. So our love should remember permanent. So here obstacles, difficulties will come in our life. Only we have four letters, L-O-V-E. But it's not so easy. If they want to become true lovers, they should have some qualities. Both should have some qualities. First, faith, understanding, confidence in their love. Faith means understanding, confidence in their love. Then only love will be successed. And she want to tell here, though day in night, for you will lie upon the wings of night, whiter than new snow on a raven's back. So ravens is nothing but it is a bird with black feathers. Black feathers. Bird with black feathers, when the snow falls on feather, how that snow will be shining. So your love will be like that. Whiter than new snow on a raven's back, come gentle night, come loving black browed night. Black. So here, come gentle night, come loving black browed night. Means here we have met in that night, and we decided on that night to become life partner. But whatever the things comes, we cannot departed one another. Act 3, in that she is expressing that whiter than new snow on a raven's back. So he was so handsome, gentle. Here she will tell what here, gentle, gentle knight. See, confident, your gentle knight, come loving, let us love. See, our love should become, means should remain forever. Mean nobody should point out should have a doubt in our love. So that much of confident in her, she is telling that, come gentle knight, come loving black browed knight. So on that night we have met, we decided to love one another, and we should not depart. Whatever the things comes, we have to face. Our love should remain forever. Whatever the means here, whichever the things comes, means even in future, maybe century after century, that our love should remain permanent. In that type we should what? Become love one another. So that is what here, even what the expression we have seen in that Romeo conversation, same equal weight depth we can see in this Juliet also. In that Juliet also expression we can see that depth. So give me my Romeo, and when I shall die, take him and cut him out in little stars. So group little stars, visible, what how the group of visible stars remain permanent, like that here. Give me my Romeo. Here she is telling confidently, me my Romeo, and when I shall die, take him and cut him out in little stars. So let us think in a beyond. It is very important while reading lines. See, it was in, he wrote, William Shakespeare wrote 16th century. At that time, while writing, his intention, what he had, that we have to catch it. So here, give me my Romeo, and when I shall die, take him and cut him out in little stars. See, it should not be temporary. Our love should remain permanent. Even after death, they have to remember. Our love should become forever, and she want to tell that, take him and cut him out in little stars. It should remain permanent. How? This star will be permanent. So that pure love, our purity in love, our pure love should remain forever. So that is what here, even equal depth towards, means feeling towards Romeo, we can see that Juliet's feelings towards Romeo. Take him and cut him out in little stars, and he will make the face of heaven so fine that all the world will be in love with night and pay no worship to the garish sun. So here, he will make the face of heaven. So once again here, our love will be remain forever. So here, face of heaven so fine that all the world will be in love with night. See, all the world will be in love with night. We have to become all over the world, that one should realize that love will not be perish. will remain forever. That type of what? Love means we should love one another. And everybody, they have to appreciate, they have to start worshipping, praying by seeing our love. So that is what here means. She tells, we should remain great lovers, and in future nobody should point out that our love is what? Our love is not ordinary one. It is permanent. And in the same line pattern, she want to say that what here, all the world will be in love with night and pay no worship to the garish, means sun, bright sun. Here they should, what here, how they will be praying what sun worship, in the same manner our love, means everybody should bow, pray, appreciate our love. So that is what here we can see in this small, in the form of here we can see poem. Basically it is a play. In that what? Play, act 1, scene 3, first part conversation have taken, and then next one here, act 3, Juliet's conversation, act 3 they have taken. So only just two dialogues here they have prescribed. So in the Romeo's part, when we come, we can see his deep feeling towards Juliet's beauty, as well as a confidence within himself to love and make it a success. In that second dialogue conversation, that same thing, Juliet, in her, even in her love, we can see the same depth, and she too tells that you are so handsome, how she is beautiful, you too was handsome, and all the abilities, qualities were there to become, means to we to become true lovers, remain as an example for generation after generation. So that we can see in this first poem, Romeo and Juliet. So that is what here. Clearly, once again, I want to say that it is only expressions from their bottom of heart, maybe Romeo as well as Juliet. So it is not a play, just only two conversation dialogues they have taken. In that we can see how beautiful she was, Juliet, and he will be go on comparing her beauty, and at last he will say that really true beauty he has not seen in his life. A same thing. So that how to maintain that true love, she too expresses that even after our death we should remain, should be what? Remember, all the generation after generation should remember that our love is true and pure. We have to remain as examples. Even their death, how they will be worshipped, sun god, all the people should start worshipping what? Our love. In that manner, let us love one another. So like that, she will keep even her feelings in front of what here has. Okay, thank you, and let us start next class with the second chapters. Thank you.